Captain Thomas and her crew of Envisioners set sail off to an uninhabited island off coast of Indonesia in search of historic treasure, guided by an historic treasure map. Stormy weather caused wreck, knocking the captain unconscious and crew members hurting. When she awoke, she found a piece of the map missing. We, the medical examiners, engineering specialists, blood spatter analysts, and forensic scientists, were asked to help with the missing map and help with the treatment of the crew.
After the storm, Dr. Smart began examining the crew and realized many of the crew members were suffering from fractured or sprained limbs. He asked us to help treat them. We used Susan kids to prepare arm, ankle, and neck splints to set the injuries. During the examinations, Dr. Smart noticed that Chief Stewart was lethargic and showing symptoms of respiratory distress, like wheezing, shortness of breath, and accelerated heart rate.
When the Chief Steward was examined, we discovered one of her lungs was collapsed. In order to learn more about the lungs and treatment options, we built model lungs.
After the shipwreck, it was discovered that some of the crew members were missing. Most importantly, First Mate Young and shipwright Neff. A search team was assembled. The team discovered that the missing crew members were on an inaccessible part of the island.
Because subparts of the island are covered in rocky terrain and venomous snakes, drones were sent out to survey the area. We built robots to help with the search to locate the missing crew members.
After building the inbots, we had to code them to follow a specific series of steps to retrieve the missing Envisioners. The night after the bad storm, the part of the island that held most of our food was flooded. To reach the food, we had to build a small bridge for the inbots to cross.
After most of the crew was treated, we began to rebuild living quarters and explore the island. One of the deck hands was found to be highly fatigued and experiencing symptoms related to cardiovascular system. Dr. Smart saw this as an opportunity to learn more about heart functions. So we dissected beef hearts provided by the doctor to help us understand his treatments.
Shipwright Neff and First Mate Young were missing. When they were found, Young was bitten on the way back to the ship. While her vision was blurry, Young claimed to have been kidnapped by Neff, but he denied it.
Dr. Smart believed that Young was suffering from mild delusions caused by a neurotoxic snake bite. However, after a close analysis, we realized that the venom was actually hemotoxic. As a physician of 15 years, he should be able to diagnose a snake bite. This implying that he may have been trying to cover for something.
Due to most of the crew being injured, it didn't surprise our captain when blood was found at the scene of the crime.
To determine whose blood it was, we created blood splatter samples from different heights and compared them to blood found at the scene.
We determined that blood was dropped from about 66 inches from the floor. This could be from a cut on one's head. Niff had a head injury, placing him at the scene of the crime.
A mysterious white powder and a couple of fingerprints were also found on scene. To find out what the powder was, it was tested and compared to known white powders found on the ship. We used vinegar, iodine, and water to test the powders, finding that the mystery powder had the same reactions to these liquids as cornstarch. Cornstarch is a neutral substance that is safe on the skin, and Neff had sunburn, placing him at the scene.
While we did not have professional fingerprinting powder, we found that cocoa powder works very similarly, so we used cocoa powder to dust for fingerprints on the cup left on scene.
After running a fingerprint analysis, we found that the fingers on the scene were loops, linking Dr. Smart to the scene of the crime.
After reviewing all of the evidence, it was clear that Neff was involved in kidnapping Young and stealing the map, but he was not alone. When Captain interviewed Neff, he confessed. As a part of his confession, Neff explained that Dr. Smart convinced him to help steal and hide the map. First Mate Young was a classic case of being in the wrong place at the wrong time. Based on all the evidence our STEM group has submitted, we believe that Dr. Smart and Shipwright Neff are guilty of stealing the ancient map.